You've heard the saying, he's carrying a lot of baggage from his past, or avoid her.
Baggage.
But think about it. I mean, baggage, it's, we get it from other people, the things that they do to us or say to us. And if we carry those memories around, in essence, we carry baggage. We begin collecting baggage when we're just little kids.
There you are.
Hey.
Hey, I need to talk to you.
Yeah, what?
Well, we were talking about building the treehouse.
Yeah. I love treehouses.
Yeah, it's just a thing. See, you can't help us build the treehouse.
Why?
Well, you don't really want me to tell you.
Yeah, I do.
Okay, well, we were talking, the gang, we were talking, and,
yeah.
Well, you're too fat.
What?
You'll weigh down the treehouse.
I'm not fat.
Yes.
No, I'm not. No. Mommy just says I'm big boned.
Dinosaurs are big boned. You're fat.
No. Mommy says I'm chunky.
Peanut butter's chunky. You're fat.
No. Mommy says that I've lost weight.
I think you found it.
No. Mommy says I'm just different.
Your mommy says you're just different?
Yeah, I'm just different.
Go back to where you came from. I gotta go. Bye.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. That's one of the biggest lies we teach children. Words hurt. They cut deep. And if we carry around the words of other people, essentially what we do is we're collecting baggage. You see, we can't find our self-worth based on what other people think of us. We have to find our self-worth based on Christ and our relationship with Him. But it doesn't seem to be that easy. And as life goes on and we get older, we just tend to collect more baggage. Sometimes we pick up baggage from people who are very close to us, like a best friend.
No, I know. I know, Shelley. I know. It's like we talked for 3 hours and it seemed like 5 minutes. I know. It's like we have this amazing connection, this chemistry. Okay, I'm just going to say this, Shelley. I've never said this to anyone in a really long time, but Shelley, I feel like you're my density. I really, really do. No, you're right. You're my destiny. That's what I meant. You're my destiny, right? I'm just so full. Hey, he's right here. I gotta go. Okay, bye.
Hey, buddy, what's up?
How much? Who are you talking to?
Talking to my mom.
Your mom's your destiny.
Yeah. I mean, she gave birth to me and everything. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Kudos.
Really?
Yeah.
Because it sounds like you said Shelley.
Yeah, that's her name.
I thought your mom's name was Kelly.
That's her middle name.
Your mom's name's Kelly Shelley?
Yeah, and she was picked on a lot when she was a kid, so I just really try to encourage her all the time and tell her that I love her. What's wrong with that?
Okay.
That's a great thing.
Whatever. Did you talk to my Shelley?
Yeah, I did.
And?
She's not gonna be your Shelley. Look, we just started talking. We just kind of hit it off. And it just happened. I mean,
what?
We had this great chemistry. It just...
No. You were supposed to call her for me.
I did. I started out doing that. I did.
No.
You gotta believe me.
You're supposed to be my best friend.
I am. Don't let a girl come between us, okay?
You did this. Look, man. You know I've liked her since we were in kindergarten, and you were supposed to talk to her for me.
Yes, but I've been your best friend since kindergarten, and we've always said growing up, best friends forever, right?
Yeah, well, you know what? Forever just got a lot shorter.
Don't do this. It's a
You did this. You're supposed to be my best friend. And our friends, they're just trying to get through life the same way we are. And sometimes they're going to make poor choices, and we can either learn to forgive them or we can pick up more baggage. You know, the truth about baggage is we don't need other people to load it on us. We do a pretty good job of dumping baggage on ourselves when we compare ourselves to others. We think things like, oh, if I could be as popular as they are, if I could be as gifted and talented as they are, but I'm not. I'm a loser. I'm no good. And when we think that, we pick up more baggage. Or we find ourselves thinking, they have it made. And why is life so easy for them and so hard for me? I'm never gonna make it. And when we buy into that lie, we more baggage. And sometimes we pick up baggage from people who love us dearly. They just don't realize that their words cut like a knife.
Son.
Hey, Dad.
What happened out there?
The ball slipped. The lights got in my eyes.
The lights got in your eyes?
Yeah.
You know that's what cost us the game, don't you?
Yeah.
The ball slipped. How many times have I gotten up in the morning before 5 a.m., before I go to work on the stuff with you, huh? There were scouts out there. You realize that?
Dad, the ball slipped.
The ball slipped.
It did. I mean, what do you want?
Hey, Coach. Huh? No. Butterfingers, yeah. We're going to work with him. Uh-huh. All right. See you later.
Are you crying?
No.
Well, don't. Pull it together. People are watching. I want you to grab your stuff. I'm going to go to the car and I'll meet you there, all right?
Dad,
I'm just disappointed in you, all right? These were our dreams, right? Grab your stuff.
And our parents, they don't mean to hurt us. It's just, they've got their own baggage. And when you don't deal with baggage, you pass it on. And for us, we have to learn to find our self-worth only in our relationship with Christ. And if we don't, we pick up more baggage. It gets uncomfortable, tedious, and our natural tendency is to want to dump this baggage onto someone else, but it always backfires.
Hey, can I ask you a question?
What are you doing in my room?
I just need to ask you a question.
What?
Can you give me and my friends a ride to school? It's cold and I don't want to ride my bike. What?
Are you really asking that?
Yeah, I don't think it's a big deal. Just give me a ride and some of my friends to school.
You need to understand something. Just because you and your loser friends are in high school now doesn't mean I'm going to give you a ride, okay? Because look at me. You need to understand that when people look at you, they see a freak, all right? And if they know that I'm related to you, if they know we're brothers, they're going to think I'm a freak too, okay? And I'm not okay with that. So here's the deal. I don't care how you get there. I don't care if you have to walk or crawl or whatever, but I'm not going to be a chauffeur for you and your loser friends, okay?
It's not my fault that Dad left. Why do you keep taking out on me?
Whatever.
No, you know I'm right.
Okay. I'm sorry.
You're not sorry. You're only sorry that I'm calling you out. I'll just ride my bike.
I said I was sorry.
I'll ride my bike.
Come on. And in the process of trying to dump our baggage on someone else, inevitably what happens is we pick up more baggage. And then there's that one. My sin. My secret sin. It's cool. I mean, I've got it under control. Who am I kidding? Most of the time it has control of me. And this is the way I live. And yet, I hear the words of Christ who says, I've come that you may have life and may have it abundantly. I don't know about you, but this doesn't really feel like abundant life to me. I can't walk straight. I can barely keep my balance. And then I remember his words. Because Christ also said, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That's what I want. That's what I want. So I go to God. God, please, if you're willing, would you take this baggage from me? Because God, I'm miserable and I can't live this way anymore. Please take it. You know what? takes.